Dear students, I will be continuing the topic Engineering Statistics and Linear Algebra. Module 1 under this, we already started single random variables, studied some of the topics. Now, let us study some application problems under this topic. Before going to application, let us brush up all the topics which we have studied. You know, CDF is the short form of cumulative density function. It is given by fx of x equal to p of capital X less than or equal to small x. What is capital X here? Capital X is the random variable. Once again, what is a random variable? Random variable is a real valued function from sample space to real set of real numbers. So cumulative density function CDF is given by this notation capital fx of x. Similarly, probability density function, we use the short form PDF. PDF is defined by f small fx of x equal to derivative of CDF. So see the difference between the notation. For CDF we use capital fx and for PDF we use small fx. So PDF is obtained by differentiating the CDF. Some of the properties of PDF which are required for our application problems. The first property, PDF is always non-negative. You cannot have any negative answer for PDF. It is actually a probability. Fx of x is greater than or equal to 0. And the second property, very important property, minus infinity to infinity integration fx of x dx equal to 1. That means when you integrate this probability density function between minus infinity to infinity, always the answer is 1. Actually, this integration gives you the area under the probability curve. So, area under the probability curve is always 1. The inverse of PDF is obtained by capital Fx of x equal to integration minus infinity to x Fx of u du. Actually, here we integrate with respect to u. You can also integrate with respect to x. But remember that here upper limit is same, x, it won't change. If you use u, when after integration we substitute upper limit value as u equal to x. But in this case, in this notation, x remains same. Okay, so this is a relationship between PDF and CDF. Once again, the first relation which we studied, derivative of CDF is PDF, and the second relation is integral of PDF is CDF. So PDF and CDF are inverses of each other. So just remember these properties. Then we studied about probability mass function. Actually, probability mass function is having the same meaning as probability density function, PDF. Usually when capital X is a discrete random variable, instead of PDF, we use the word PDF, PMF, probability mass function. So remember, both are equivalent. In some textbooks, they may give you only one name, PDF, but both are same. So what is probability mass function? If your capital X is a discrete random variable. Discrete random variable means the values of X can be listed in this form, X1, X2, etc. Okay. So when the values of X can be listed, we can find the probability, that probability mass function, it satisfies these two properties. The first property is summation. The first property is probability of xi greater than or equal to 0. That means all probability values are greater than or equal to 0. And the second property is summation I equal to 1 to infinity, p of xi is equal to 1. Once again, recall the same two properties we studied for the continuous random variable PDF. These two properties, fx of x is greater than or equal to 0, and integration minus infinity to infinity fx of x dx is equal to 1. But in the case of discrete random variable, the same two properties are written in this form. P of xi are greater than or equal to 0 and summation I equal to 1 to infinity P of xi equal to 1. So if x is a continuous random variable, we use integration, and if x is a discrete random variable, we use summation. Remember this point. Continuous random variable means integration and discrete random variable means summation. We studied expected value, expectation of a random variable. So if x is a random variable which is continuous, in the case of continuous random variable, we use integration. So if x is a continuous random variable, its mean value x bar is given by minus infinity to infinity integration of x into fx of x dx. Fx of x is pdf. Now here we can also use the notation expectation of x, e of x instead of x bar, and sometimes we also use the notation mu x, mu suffix x for the expectation. So among the expectations, the three main expectations in use are given by e of x is equal to minus infinity to infinity x into fx of x dx, which is already given here. It is the first moment about origin, another name for this, first moment about origin. E of x square or x square bar, just like x bar, here we are finding x square bar, expectation of x square. It is given by minus infinity to infinity x square into fx of x dx. Another name for this is second moment about origin. Expectation of x minus mu x whole square. This is another expectation which is used in many of the problems. Expectation of x minus mu x whole square. And it is given by minus infinity to infinity x minus mu x whole square into fx of x dx. So all these three formulas are given for continuous random variable capital X. And if the random variable is discrete, instead of integration, we use summation. If discrete random variables are given, here instead of minus infinity to infinity, we write summation minus infinity to infinity x int fx of x. And here in the case of discrete random variable, we write summation x square fx of x. And here summation x minus mu x whole square into fx of x. So for the PDF or PMF of a discrete random variable, we may use the notation fx of x or p of x. We also studied about characteristic functions. For the characteristic function, we use the notation phi x of j omega. It is another form of expectation. It is given by expectation of e to the power j omega x. So characteristic function phi x of j omega is given by expectation of e to the power j omega x. And in this notation, what is j? J is square root of minus 1 and omega is a parameter. So it is given by minus infinity to infinity fx of x into e to the power j omega x dx. If you remember the definition of Fourier transform, actually this resembles the definition of Fourier transform. In Fourier transform, you studied integration minus infinity to infinity f of x into e raised to minus isx dx. If you remember, isx dx, there I means square root of minus 1. So here instead of I, we use the notation j. J is also square root of minus 1. And in the place of s of Fourier transform, here we use omega. So fx of x e raised to j omega x dx. And characteristic function and the PDF. If characteristic function is given, you can find its PDF. It is given by 1 by 2 pi minus infinity to infinity phi x of j omega e to the power minus j omega x d omega. So here we, our integration is with respect to x. So omega remains in your answer. So this will be finally a function containing j and omega. But in this case, we are integrating with respect to omega. So x remains in your answer. So we use the notation fx of x. So these two are Fourier transforms pairs. Anyway, we are interested only in this formula, characteristic function. How to find the characteristic function when a PDF is given to you, fx of x is given to you. And the same characteristic function formula, if you are using the discrete random variable, then instead of minus infinity to infinity integration, we use summation. So remember, integration means continuous random variable, summation means discrete random variable. We also studied moments. Just now I told you, moments means if you are finding expectation of x, it is called as first moment. Expectation of x square is called as second moment. Expectation of x cube is called as third moment. So we can use the characteristic function and find the moments. Expectation of x or x square or x cube, etc. For any value of n, we can find the moment. We call it as nth moment. So for that, we differentiate this characteristic function phi x of j omega n times. With respect to which variable we differentiate here? We differentiate with respect to j omega, because phi x of j omega is a function of j omega. So we differentiate with respect to j omega. So if you differentiate once with respect to j omega and then put omega equal to 0, it gives you expectation of x to the power 1. If you differentiate this phi x of j omega twice with respect to j omega and then put omega equal to 0, then it gives you expectation of x square. So in general, I am giving you the formula here. Nth moment. Nth moment means expectation of x to the power n. It is given by differentiating the characteristic function phi x of j omega n times. N times you need to differentiate with respect to j omega. And then in the resulting answer, we put omega equal to 0. So your ordinary knowledge of differentiation is required here. We also studied some distributions. First among them was the uniform distribution. So just remember the PDF, mean and variance of these distributions. For application problems, we need to remember mean, variance and PDF of some of the standard distributions. So this is one of the standard distributions, uniform distribution. Fx of x, PDF of uniform distribution, is given by 1 by b minus a, where x is in between a and b, a less than or equal to x less than or equal to b, and elsewhere in remaining region function value is 0. So when you use this is a continuous random variable, so to find the mean, actually you have to use integration formula, integration minus infinity to infinity fx of x dx, and when you use that integral and evaluate, you get the answer a plus b by 2. So for working out some problems, just remember these values. A plus b by 2 is the mean value of uniform distribution, and variance of uniform distribution is b minus a whole square divided by 12. For variance, we use a formula, expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. Variance formula is expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. Or another formula is expectation of x minus mu x whole square, where mu x is mean. Okay, so another notation for mean is mu x, mu suffix x. So this is about uniform distribution. Remember the PDF of uniform distribution as well as mean and variance. The next distribution which you studied is exponential distribution. The PDF of exponential distribution is given by this. Function value is lambda into e to the power minus lambda x. If x is greater than 0, and in remaining region 0 otherwise. Using unistep function also you can write this function. This PDF can be written like this: lambda into e exponential of minus lambda x into u of x, where this u of x value is 1. If x is greater than 0, unistep function value is 1. And if x is less than or equal to 0, u of x value is 0. So instead of writing two steps definition like this, we can make use of unistep function. It is understood when u of x is greater than 0, this value becomes 1. So you get only lambda into e to the power minus lambda x. And when u of x value is 0, that means when x is less than or equal to 0, this value is 0. That means your this full product becomes 0. So answer is 0. And mean value of exponential distribution is 1 by lambda. So remember this formula: mean value of exponential distribution is 1 by lambda. Variance is 1 by lambda square. Again, how to find this mean? Just recall the method which you have studied. To find the mean, we are using minus infinity to infinity integration of fx of x dx. Why we are using integration? This is a continuous random variable. X greater than 0 means you cannot list all the values taken by x, so it is a continuous random variable. So using that continuous random variable formula for mean, we obtain mean equal to 1 by lambda. And variance is given by 1 by lambda square. Already we derived in one of our classes. The third distribution which you studied is Laplace distribution. Laplace random variable has the PDF given by fx of x is equal to b by 2 into e to the power minus b into mod x. And the range is minus infinity to infinity. X can take any value from minus infinity to infinity. And here b is a constant which is greater than 0. It is a positive constant. Again, this is a continuous random variable because we cannot list values taken by x in this interval. It's a continuous random variable. And hence, for the mean, we make use of the formula minus infinity to infinity fx of x dx. Fx of x dx. When you use that integral, you get the answer as 0. Once again, recall how you obtained answer as 0. When you are multiplying by x, and this is an even function, so product becomes odd function. For odd function, when you integrate in this interval minus infinity to infinity, integration of odd function is always 0. So once again, go through your notes, go through the derivation of mean and variance which you have studied. And variance is 2 by b square. So remember, Laplace random variable, mean is 0 and variance is 2 by b square. Next distribution you studied is Gaussian and normalized Gaussian. In many cases we use only normalized Gaussian distribution. Gaussian distribution has the PDF in this form: p of x equal to, okay, here we used p of x, you can also use fx of x. So p of x or fx of x equal to 1 by sigma into square root of 2 pi e to the power minus x minus mu whole square by 2 sigma square. All these are inside exponential function. We can also write exp of as we have written here in some of the problems here. Exp of. This way also we can write the PDF of normal random variable. Exp of minus of x minus mu whole square by 2 sigma square. And mean of this distribution is mu. And variance of this distribution is sigma square. Using mean and variance only, we are writing this distribution. Mu and sigma are included in the distribution itself. Mu and sigma square. Standard deviation is, as usual, sigma square root of variance. But we are interested in the random variable, which is taking the special value for mu and sigma. If mu is 0, mean value is 0, and the standard deviation sigma is 1, in that case, the Gaussian random variable reduces to normalized Gaussian random variable. We call it as normalized Gaussian or standard normal random variable. Its PDF is given like this: fz of z. Instead of x of fx of x, you can also write fz of z. Fz of z is given by 1 by square root of 2 pi e to the power minus z square by 2. So this is obtained by using this distribution. By using the substitution, in the place of x minus mu by sigma, we use z. So x minus mu whole square by sigma square becomes z square. So we get this distribution. Mean is mu equal to 0. As I mentioned you here, mu is 0. And standard deviation is sigma equal to 1. So remember, normalized Gaussian random variable or standard normal variable means it is with Gaussian random variable with mu equal to 0 and sigma equal to 1. Next, we studied binomial distribution. All the previous distributions, that may be uniform distribution, exponential distribution, Gaussian distribution, Laplace distribution, all these distributions are continuous distributions. That means distributions of a continuous random variable. But binomial distribution is a distribution of discrete random variable. Once again, recall, what is binomial distribution? Before binomial distribution, let us discuss about Bernoulli trials. Bernoulli trial means when you have an experiment which contains only two types of outcomes, then it is called as a Bernoulli trial. Best example is tossing a coin. When you toss a coin, we get either head or tail, only two types of outcomes. So this type of trial is called a Bernoulli trial. So when you repeat this Bernoulli trial n times independently, when you repeat a Bernoulli trial n times independently, then the distribution obtained is binomial distribution. Its PDF is given by P of x is equal to, okay, this is another notation used for PDF of binomial. B means binomial, x means the variable, n is the number of trials. So when you repeat Bernoulli trial n times, so n is the trial, number of trials, and P is probability of success in each trial. Probability of success in each trial. For example, if you are tossing a coin 10 times, what is the chance of success in one trial? For that, you have to define the success. What is success for you? You have to define it. Getting head may be a success for you, or getting tail may be a success for you. So if you define head as the success, then what is the chance of getting head? That is your probability P here. P means probability of success. So its PDF is given by probability function or probability density function or probability mass function of binomial random variable is given by NCX. This is the notation for the combinations, NCX. NCX P raised to X 1 minus P raised to N minus X. And here X can take the values 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. When you perform N trials, out of N trials, you may get success either 0 number of times or once or twice, etc. So X takes discrete values 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. So it is a discrete random variable. Here N is number of trials, P is probability of success, and mean of the binomial random variable. We already derived this formula. It is given by N into P. How to derive mean of binomial random variable? Binomial random variable is a discrete random variable. So while finding the mean, we make use of the formula summation, not integration, summation. Summation X into P of X. Summation of X into P of X. Similarly, variance of binomial distribution is given by NP into 1 minus P. The next distribution, once again, this is a discrete distribution. The values of X are discrete. It is given by Poisson, which is called as Poisson distribution, whose PDF is given by this. Here X values, I have not mentioned X values here. Actually X values may be from 0 to infinity. In the binomial distribution, n gives you number of trials. In binomial distribution, n gives you number of trials. When that n value is very large, usually when n is more than 30, we consider it as large number. When n is very large, we use Poisson distribution, whose PDF is given by this. So n is very large means n can take the values till infinity. So values of number of successes, x can be listed. How many successes are there out of infinitely many trials? Sometimes you may get 0 success, x equal to 0, or x equal to 1. Number of successes may be only 1 out of infinitely many trials, or x equal to 2. So values taken by x can be listed here, x equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. It varies till infinity. It varies till infinity. So this is a discrete random variable. And remember the PDF. For application problems, we need to remember the PDF. Here lambda is a parameter, and this lambda is equal to np of your binomial distribution. In binomial distribution, mean of the random variable is n into p. You can see in the previous slide, mean is n into p. The same mean is here lambda. So mean is equal to lambda for the Poisson distribution, and variance is also lambda. So Poisson distribution is an example for a distribution where both mean and variance are equal. We already derived these two answers. Now let us go to some application problems. So to solve these application problems, you need all the review topics which I explained before. The first example, a discrete random variable x has the probability mass function or probability density function given by this table. X values are given and corresponding probability fx of x. Sometimes they may use only f of x, but meaning is same. Fx of x is given. K, 2k, 2k, 3k, k square, 2k square, 7k square plus k. The question is, find the value of k and evaluate p of x less than 3 and p of x greater than or equal to 6. Now how to decide whether the given random variable is discrete or continuous? Check the values here, whether values of x are listed here. Yes, so since values of x are listed, it is a discrete random variable. For discrete random variable, here the probabilities are given in terms of unknown value k. So let us first find the value of k. Since x is a discrete random variable, the PDF should satisfy the following two conditions. Once again, recall the conditions which you have studied. The first condition, all PDF values are greater than or equal to 0. And second condition, summation, discrete random variable, so we use summation. Summation minus infinity to infinity, fx of x is equal to 1. Now let us use the second condition to evaluate k. What is the second condition? Summation of all fx of x values will be equal to 1. So actually when you take x equal to 1, here available values of x in the data are 1 to 7. So when you substitute x equal to 1, 2, 3, etc. till 7, we get the summation of all fx of x. And that value should be equal to 1 according to our second condition. Substitute. What is f of 1? See the table again. F of 1 is k. F of 2 is 2k. F of 3 is 2k. Like this, substitute all values. F of 1 is k. F of 2 is 2k. F of 3 is 2k. So continue like this until you reach f of 7. And sum of all these values are equal to 1 from our rule. Simplify this. You can add all similar terms, k square terms together, and all k terms together, you get 10k square plus 9k equal to 1. When you simplify further, you get actually 10k square plus 9k minus 1 equal to 0. This is a quadratic equation. You can solve the quadratic equation using any method. Which are the methods available to solve the quadratic equation? Either you can make use of your calculator, or you can use that minus b when you have a quadratic equation in the form ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. What is the formula to find x? Minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac divided by 2a. Another equivalent method is try to split this into two factors. So I tried to split into two factors. I have written this 9k as 10k minus k. Okay, so that here you get 10 as the common term. 10k is the common term, k plus 1. And from these two terms, minus sign is common. Minus 1 into k plus 1. This is equal to 0. This gives you 10k minus 1 into k plus 1 equal to 0. We get two answers. Which are the answers? K value is either minus 1 or 1 by 10. But k cannot take negative values. What is our first condition of PDF? All p of x values are greater than or equal to 0. If k takes negative 1, then our first condition will not be satisfied. Go back to the table and check it. If this k is negative 1, then your f of x value is negative 1. It will not satisfy this condition. So, we select k equal to 1 by 10. So, this gives you the answer for our first question, value of k. What is our second question? Evaluate p of x less than 3. X less than 3 means all lesser values of x less than 3 are considered. How many values of x are there in the table? Less than 3 means you have only 1 and 2. So add corresponding probabilities. P of x equal to 1 plus p of x equal to 2. This gives you p of x less than 3. P of x greater than or equal to 6. See the inequality properly. Greater than or equal to 6. Equal to is also included here. How to find p of x greater than or equal to 6? X equal to 6 is included as well as x equal to 7 is included. Add the corresponding probabilities. So I am showing the solution part here. P of x less than 3 means p of x equal to 1 plus x equal to 2. That means f of 1 plus f of 2 from the given table. F of 1 is k. K is nothing but 1 by 10. Substitute. Plus f of 2 is 2k. So 2 by 10. When you add these two, you get 3 by 10. Or equivalently, you can write 0.3. The next question, p of x greater than or equal to 6 means 6 is included here. So x equal to 6. Probability of x equal to 6 plus probability of x equal to 7. From the table, it gives you 2k square plus 7k square plus k. When x equal to 6, you have corresponding probability as 2k square. When you substitute for k square, you get 2 by 100. Okay, there is a mistake here. This should be 1 by 10 square, not 1 by 100 square, 1 by 10 square. So 2k square, correct it. So when you square it, you get 1 by 100 in the next step. So this is correct step. Here you correct the step. Plus 7k square plus k. 7k square plus k is 7 into 1 by 100 plus 1 by 10. So when you simplify this, you get 19 by 100. That is the required answer for your second sub-question. So remember here, we used conditions for discrete random variable. And to find any probability, we use the summation. Now let us go to the next example. Here, the table of data is not given. In the previous example, data is given in the form of a table. But here table is not given. So your first work is, you prepare the data. What is the question here? If the random variable x takes the values 1, 2, 3, and 4 such that 2 into probability of x equal to 1 is 3 into probability of x equal to 2 is equal to p of x equal to 3 minus 5 p times x equal to 4. Now here x takes the values 1, 2, 3, 4. So clearly it is discrete. Now let us take any one notation as p of x equal to 3 equal to k. Then what is 2 into p of x equal to 1, the first value? This becomes 2k. Sorry, p of x equal to 3 is k, so this is equal to k. 2 into p of x is equal to 1 equal to k, that means p of x equal to 1 is k by 2. Similarly, 3 into p of x equal to 2 is k, so p of x equal to 2 is k by 3. Similarly, 5 into, here it is equal to notation, not minus, here it is equal to notation, correct it. 5 into p of x equal to 4 is k, this is equal to k, that implies p of x equal to 4 is k by 5. Now you have all the probabilities for x equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, we have the probabilities here in terms of k. So we can prepare the table or directly you can continue. What is the second condition for the probability density function or probability mass function? Summation of all p of xi is equal to 1. Substitute. When x equal to 1, 2, 3 and 4, x equal to 1 it is k by 2, x equal to 2 it is k by 3, x equal to 3 it is k and x equal to 4 it is k by 5. Add all the 4 answers. Sum should be equal to 1. This is the second condition of PMF. Solving this, you get 61k by 30 equal to 1. You can add and check it. That implies k equal to 30 by 61. So you got the value of k. That is our first question. Actually, k is not asked here directly, but without finding k, you cannot continue. Next question, find the probability distribution function, that means PDF. So after finding k value, we are substituting here. Actually, p of x equal to 1 is k by 2. So when you divide this by 2, you get 15 by 61. P of x equal to 2 is k by 3. So you get 10 by 61. P of x equal to 3 is k, 30 by 61. P of x equal to 4 is 6 by 61, 5k. So k by 5k is k equal to 30 by 61. That means this is 6 by 61. So we obtained the probability density function in the form of a table. Why it is a discrete random variable now? Values of x are listed. CDF. To find the cumulative density function, that is probability of x less than or equal to x, we can consider the cases, different cases. In the table above here, we don't know whether x is less than 1 or x is in between these or x is in this interval or x is in this interval or x is greater than 4. So if x is less than 1, what happens? If x is in the interval 1 and 2, greater than 1 and less than 2, what happens? If x is in between 2 and 3, what is the corresponding CDF? So we will consider each case separately here. If x is less than 1, then CDF is 0. Cumulative density function. Cumulative means we add all the values up to that particular value of x. So clearly in the given data, given table, there is no value of x below x equal to 1. So x corresponding CDF is 0. If x is greater than or equal to 1 and less than 2, greater than or equal to 1 means 1 is included but 2 is not included. In that case, see the previous table. 1 is included, 2 is not included. So what is the addition up to x equal to 1? 15 by 61. We write here. This is 15 by 61. If x is in between 2 and 3, x is greater than or equal to 2 and less than 3, third case. In that case, 2 is included, greater than or equal to 2. 1 is included, 2 is included, but 3 is not included. So we get x equal to 1 and x equal to 2 values. Probabilities are added. 25 by 61 is the answer. So when x is greater than or equal to 2, that means above this, but below 3. 3 is not included. Both values are added, cumulative. 15 by 61 plus 10 by 61. You get 25 by 61. Similarly, if x is in between 3 and 4, x is greater than or equal to 3 and less than 4. In that case, cumulative density function is p of x equal to 1, 1 is included, 2 is included, 3 is included, but not 4. X is less than 4, strictly less than 4. So adding all these three probabilities, we get the answer 55 by 61. You substitute for these three values, add and verify the answer. If x is greater than or equal to 4, if x is above 4, after this, right side of this, clearly there is no function defined. So greater than or equal to 4 means all the previous values are included. X is greater than or equal to 4. So x is here. We are finding probability of x less than or equal to x. So less than or equal to 4, all values are included. 1, 2, 3, 4. Final answer will be equal to 1. So I think it is understood. When table is given and when table is not given with some conditions, how to solve the problems. Now let us go to a very simple example under continuous random variable. A continuous random variable is given with the PDF 3x square. 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1. Find a such that p of x less than a is 0.05. Here PDF is given here and some condition is given with unknown term a. For which value of a, probability of s greater than a becomes 0.05. We are going to find now. What is the condition for p of x greater than a? Since your x is a continuous random variable, for all values of x greater than a are taken. So it is integration. Integration from a to 1. Actually, integration from a to infinity. But here, using this interval, upper limit is 1. After 1, it is not defined. So we take a equal to limits from a to 1. Fx of x dx. Answer is given 0.05. Use the answer. Try to simplify this. What is fx of x from a to 1? Here we assume that a is greater than 0. A is in this interval. With that condition, we find 3x square dx is 0.05. Substitute. When you substitute and integrate, we get lower limit as a, and when you substitute this a, you get this answer. 3 into 1 minus a cube by 3, which is equal to 0.05. Simplify this. 1 minus a cube becomes 0.05. What is 0.05 in terms of p by q? 5 by 100. That means 1 by 20. So when you take LCM and add the terms, your a cube becomes 1 minus 1 by 20. Rearrange the terms. A cube shifted to right hand side. You get 1 minus 1 by 20 equal to a cube, which is 19 by 20. So what is the value of a? 19 by 20 to the power 1 by 3. This is another type of question. By giving some unknown constants, they may ask you to find the value of that constant. A equal to 19 by 20 to the power 1 by 13. So your question was to find the value of a satisfying this condition. Once again recall, we started from the condition, applied the values, integrated, and then we get the answer. A cube equal to 19 by 20. So a will be 19 by 20 to the power 1 by 3. One more example from continuous random variable. The probability density function of a random variable x is f of x equal to x into e to the power minus x into u of x. As I mentioned you, sometimes we may use the notation u of x. What is the meaning of u of x? U of x value is 1, unit step function, value is 1 when x is greater than 0, and this u of x value is 0 when x is less than or equal to 0. So using the definition of u of x, you may also write the given f of x in this form. F of x is x into e to the power minus x if x greater than 0, 0 otherwise. Question is to find CDF. CDF. CDF means cumulative density function. For CDF, fx of x, since this is a continuous random variable, here x greater than 0 means we cannot list the values. They have not mentioned whether it is integer or real number. So when it is not mentioned, always it is considered as real number. So x greater than 0, we cannot list the values, so it is a continuous random variable, and so we use the integration minus infinity to x integration of f of x dx. Now we don't know where your upper limit x lies. Your x may be less than 0, it may come in this region or it may come in this region. So let us consider each case separately. When x is less than 0, your fx of x cdf becomes minus infinity to x f of x dx as per the definition. But minus infinity to x, when x is less than 0, it comes under the second definition, f of x value is 0. So when you substitute f of x and integrate, answer will be 0. So cdf value is 0 if x is greater less than or equal to 0. Now second case, we will consider the possibility of x value in this interval, that means when x is greater than 0. When x is greater than 0, from the definition of fx of x, minus infinity to x. So clearly x is greater than 0 means in your real line x will be right side of 0. But we are starting our counting technique from minus infinity. So minus infinity to till x we are integrating. So you need to split the interval. Minus infinity to till 0, one part of the integral, and then 0 to x. Why we are splitting the interval here? Your x is to on the right side of your x equal to 0, x is greater than 0. So left side means minus infinity to till 0, right side from 0 to till x we integrate. So this becomes 0 plus, clearly this is 0 because this comes under your second definition of f of x, and 0 to x, x into e to the power minus x dx. Integrate this, you are having product of two functions. To evaluate integral of product of two functions, we need integration by parts. So here I used the Bernoulli's rule. What is the Bernoulli's rule? If you have u into v dx, formula gives you u into integral of v. So u is x. Integral of v means e raised to minus x by minus 1. Then minus u dash. U dash means derivative of x. I have not written the formula here, Bernoulli's rule. Just recall the Bernoulli's rule. Here it is u dash. U dash is 1 into integral of v1. This is actually v1, first integral. Its integral. Integral of this. E raised to minus x by minus 1 into minus 1. You get minus 1 whole square. Anyway, it becomes 1, this value. Substitute. Apply the limits from 0 to x. Upper limit is same. Keep upper limit as it is. But lower limit, put x equal to 0. In that case, you get 1 minus x plus 1 into e to the power minus x. This is CDF value when x is greater than 0, second case. So we have considered both cases, when x is less than or equal to 0 and when x is greater than 0. We can combine both cases and write a single function here. CDF is given by 1 minus x plus 1 e raised to minus x into u of x if x is greater than 0, 0 otherwise. Instead of, here actually u of x is not required when you use the interval. You have to cancel this u of x. Instead of this u of x, here you write without interval, we write u of x here. It is understood, so make this correction. You have to cancel this u of x. There is no u of x here, but here you have u of x. And what is the next question? So we obtained the CDF. Go to the question now. CDF is obtained. What is the second question? Evaluate p of x less than or equal to 1. X is less than or equal to 1 means all x values till 1 are considered. But since your PDF is continuous random variable, we make use of integration. So this is integration from minus infinity to 1. Here only from 1 to 2 we integrate. Integration from 1 to 2. And here x is greater than 2 means integration will be from 2 to infinity. So let us go to the solution part. P of x less than or equal to 1 means integration from minus infinity to till 1 f of x dx. But minus infinity to 0, you don't have the function, it is 0. So consider only from 0 to 1. 0 to 1. X into e to the power minus x dx. Evaluate the integral as usual using integration by parts or Bernoulli's rule. You get and apply the limits. You get 0.264. While applying the limits, remember that e to the power 0 you are getting lower limit. E to the power 0 is 1, not 0. Because sometimes you may take the value wrongly. So e to the power 0 value is 1. And e to the power minus 1 value, upper limit value, you can use the calculator for that. And finally write the simplified answer, 0.264. This is the answer for your second question, p of x less than or equal to 1. Third question was p of 1 less than x less than or equal to 2. So lower limit and upper limit both are mentioned. So just integrate from 1 to 2. 1 to 2 f of x dx. F of x or fx of x you can write. 1 to 2 comes in the first interval. X is greater than 0. So substitute. Fx of x is x into e raised to minus x dx. Integrate by parts. And apply the limits. Here I have written one more step. I have written the substitution step. When you apply the upper limit and lower limit, you get this term. Evaluate this using the calculator. You get the answer 0.33. How to use e to the power minus, how to calculate e to the power minus 1 using your calculator? In most of the calculators, you have shift key with the e to the power x key gives you log. So directly you have e to the power x key. So use that key and evaluate this. You get the answer 0.33. So the fourth part of this question is p of x greater than 2. So clearly all values of x greater than 2 are taken. 2 to infinity f of x dx. Integration from 2 to infinity f of x dx. Substitute. 2 to infinity means clearly x is greater than 0. So you can use the first definition, x e raised to minus x dx. Integrate. Apply the limits from 2 to infinity. Simplify your answer after integration. Finally you get 0.406. So let us work out more problems in our next video.